Say goodbye to your hard drive, asshole.
Harburg's office,
how may I help you? Hi, my name's Curtis Craig, and I was referred to Dr. Harburg by somebody, and I was wondering if I could make an appointment.
Certainly. Let me see. You're in luck, Mr. Craig. We have a cancellation today at 5:30.
Okay, I guess.
Wonderful. See you soon, Mr. Craig. Bye-bye now.
Hey, Miss Bob.
Hey, pretty girl.
Yeah, you're the prettiest rat in the world, aren't you? All right, just don't get cocky, huh?
Thinking of you, whips and kisses, tea.
Thanks for your cooperation, folks. I know this hasn't been easy. Detective Powell will contact you if you have any more questions.
I got here early, and I went into your cube to see if you were in yet, and Bob, Bob was there.
It looks like someone got just sick of Bob.
An active crime scene, sir. I'm gonna have to ask you to stay out of the area.
Yes, we did.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I'm not sure. That's been taken care of. Yes. I doubt it, sir.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
In case you didn't notice, this is an active crime scene. Back off. What's your name, sir?
Curtis Craig.
That your cubicle?
Yeah.
Detective Allie Powell. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Detective, exactly what weapon was used to do that to Bob?
Weapons, Mr. Craig. Several X-Acto knives, a box cutter, and a heavy-duty stapler. Hmm. What was your relationship to the deceased man, Bob Arnold?
He was just my coworker.
Did you like Bob Arnold?
No.
Why didn't you like Mr. Arnold, Mr. Craig?
He was an ass. He was a creep, detective. He was a backstabbing sleaze.
I see.
Who are you?
Just a witness to your crimes.
Who are you talking to?
Oh, no one.
Please stop it.
You're obviously overwrought, Mr. Craig. We'll continue this another time. Good morning.
Curtis, I'm calling a sort of impromptu meeting at the Dreaming Tree. I think we all need to get out of here for a while.
Yeah, okay.
Thanks for coming, everybody. A really tragic thing happened today. Tragic and horrible. If anybody should want to talk to a grief counselor, the company will make one available to you. I don't know what else to say, guys. I'll go get some drinks.
It's just so awful. I can't believe it.
Yeah.
Guys, I don't feel real well. Tell Tom I had to go, okay?
Sure, Trev.
You know, I never much liked Bob. No one deserved that. No one.
Oh, I don't know. What about Charles Manson? I mean, if it was good enough for Bob, it's certainly good enough for Jolly Charlie.
Are you all right, Curtis? You're acting really weird.
Oh, geez, I'm sorry, Joss. I guess finding disemboweled dead guys in my cubicle just throws me right the fuck off.
Fine. Why don't you call me when you're done being an asshole?
You really held it together when you saw Bob splattered all over your cubicle. Cool as a cucumber.
Yeah, my head was in a really weird place. I felt removed, like it wasn't really real.
You know, I don't really feel bad for Bob. I think the bad karma fairy got him.
Bad karma fairy, huh? Ah, she sounds like one dangerous bitch.
Yep. She stomped on his head with her wicked 6-inch heels. Curtis, let's cut to the chase. I've told you how I feel about you, and you've put up your nice guy protest, but we're through dancing. Meet me at the Borderline tonight.
Borderline? What, the club?
Mm-hmm.
Never been there.
Here's the address. I'll be there at 7. Don't disappoint me.
Where'd everybody go?
Hey, rat girl. I don't suppose you know what the hell's going on, huh?
Isn't it obvious? You're a psycho killer.
Caught dead. Leech therapy. Lobotomy is the answer. What the hell? Didn't kill anyone.
Of course you did.
Hey, my man. Aren't you supposed to be basking in the warm, fluorescent lights of Wintech?
Nope. School got called due to murder. Bob Arnold got himself butchered like a pig in my cubicle, no less.
No way.
Yeah.
Well, that is harsh, man. So, was Bob totally messed up, or what? I mean, was he like knifed?
Exacto knifed and stapled. Among other things.
Stapled?
Yeah.
Holy shit. He must have really pissed somebody off in shipping. So, like, were you totally grossed out when you saw Bob cut up? Did you puke?
No. I don't know, I didn't feel much of anything. It's kind of like seeing a dead cat in the road, you know?
You must have been in total shock, huh?
Yeah, it must have been.
This now. You were supposed to have those requisitions months ago. Yes. No. All right.
What do you think you're doing here?
I just came to pick up some work to take home.
Are you out of your mind? You can't take anything from a crime scene. Get out of here!
Yeah, that'd be a smart move.
P.A. Warner.
Hi, Mr. Warner, this is Tom. We need you in the fourth floor conference room right away. Uh-huh.
Just what would you be doing in my office when I'm not here, Curtis?
I was just,
Let's say we cut the crap. You've been poking around in places you don't belong. Don't make the same mistakes your father made, boy. I would hate to have to lose you.
Sorry, Mr. Warner.
Monster? Well, I'm not the monster, Curtis.
That would be your daddy.
No!
Yes! He committed atrocities
to stir the stomach of Joseph Mengele. He wallowed in death. No!
Threshold.
bolted in.
That's not gonna work.
Hello. I'm Dr. Harburg.
Nice to meet you, Doctor.
Nice to meet you. Go ahead and have a seat. Make yourself comfortable. So, what brings you here today?
Well, I've been having some trouble dealing with things lately. I keep getting freaked out by, nothing. I don't know where to start.
It's okay. Take your time. Talk about anything that comes into your mind.
Look, no offense, but I am not very comfortable with this. Being here makes me feel like some kind of a wacko or something.
You're not a wacko, Curtis. There's no stigma attached to analysis anymore. Your brain is just like any other part of your body, and when it isn't feeling well, not only is it okay to get help, but it's smart.
I almost didn't call you, because Dr. Merrick referred me to you. He was my doctor at the hospital.
Yes, I know, Curtis. Would you like to talk about your hospitalization, about Dr. Merrick? I'm not going to ask you anything specific about your hospitalization, but could you tell me if perhaps there was one single inciting incident that led up to it?
See, that's the thing, Doctor. I don't know what happened. One minute I knew who I was, and then the next minute, I had no idea. It's hard to explain, but my identity just came apart like old rotten lace. This guy I work with, Bob, was murdered today. I don't mean just shot in the head either. He was spread all over my cubicle.
Oh my God, Curtis, how are you feeling about this?
That's the thing, Doctor. I don't feel anything. I don't feel anything at all. This was taken at our company Christmas party. I had a lot of fun that night, I guess.
Looks like you were having fun. Who are those people with you?
That's Trevor. He's my best friend. And that's Jocelyn. She's my, she's my lover. Yeah, it's funny. I've been keeping our relationship at work a secret.
Are you in love with Jocelyn?
Yeah, I think so. But I'm kind of attracted to Trevor.
And that worries me because I've never... I mean, I don't want to... I don't know if I should be with Jocelyn. I don't want to hurt her, you know?
Have you spoken to Jocelyn about this?
God, no. I have enough trouble opening up to her. You know, it's funny. Even when we're making love, I don't feel totally close to her. I don't think I felt totally close to anyone. I have a date with this girl from my work tonight. Her name's Therese. She is very sexy, and I don't know, though. I'm feeling guilty because of my girlfriend, Jocelyn.
Well, do you feel like you're betraying Jocelyn?
Yeah. Well, I mean, no. I mean, okay, we agreed from the beginning that it wasn't exclusive, right? So I don't have any reason to be guilty at all, do I?
Well, I think that's for you to decide in your own mind and in your own heart. But let me point out, however, Curtis, that guilt is a very, very destructive emotion.
It's kind of embarrassing, but that kind of imagery has always fascinated me.
It's nothing to be ashamed of, Curtis. Have you ever thought about why you like images of bondage?
Yeah. It's even weirder. I feel like the person in the picture is somehow being held together. Like they can't come apart with all that stuff holding them in.
Fascinating.
These are my parents. Don't they look happy? I think they were happy then, but I don't remember. It's not fair, you know? I don't remember any of the good stuff. I don't remember my mother ever hugging me or kissing me or just hitting me. I remember when she killed herself. A couple years later, my father was run down by a drunk in an old Plymouth.
Oh, my God, Curtis. That's a lot for anybody to deal with.
My mother used to have a snowstorm like this. I used to think that must be what her mind looks like. All broken up. All those tiny pieces swirling around inside. She started hating me when I was about 6.
That was her problem, not yours. You were just a little boy.
Doctor. Oh, damn, this is hard. Long before my mother killed herself, she
started dressing me up as a little girl.
Pretty dress. It just doesn't matter. Doesn't matter how I dress you, you'd still be a monster. Pretty little monster.
That the problem was entirely hers. You were an innocent child.
So do you think that my mother dressing me like Barbie has anything to do with my being attracted to Trevor?
No. No, Curtis, I don't. Sexual orientation is genetic. However, the confusion that your mother instilled in you may be contributing to your disassociation with society.
Dr. Harburg, I think that the company that I work for is conducting some sort of terrible illegal experiment. Take a look at this. My father was deeply involved. I have to find out what the Threshold Project is about.
Well, it's not impossible, Curtis. There have been huge corporate cover-ups over the years. Well, Curtis, our session's up, but I think we have a lot of work to do. How do you feel about coming back tomorrow?
Oh, okay, I guess.
Wonderful. I'll see you then.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Harper.
You're very welcome. Have a good evening.
You too. Therese Banning. She asked me to meet her here.
So you know her name. Big frickin' deal. Doesn't mean she invited you.
Look, Therese sent this to me.
Yeah, right. It's not even signed.
Therese gave this to me, see?
Yeah, okay. Come on in. Don't get yourself hurt now.
Excuse me.
Get away from there. You have no business going into the pit.
What club is this, anyway?
It's an S&M club, Curtis. Do you need a drink to cope with the ugly truth?
No, thanks. Mine is pretty intriguing.
Oh, it gets better, baby.
Listen, I have to tell you something. Jocelyn and I are pretty serious about each other, and...
You know what? I don't really care. Do you think you're the only one I'm seeing? You know, I used to bring her along sometimes. She's pretty cute.
Truth. I'm not being judgmental or anything.
Hey, can I have a red shiny rubber?
I just don't understand why people need to feel pain to have fun.
Have you ever been whipped, Curtis? Have you ever been oiled down in candlelight and beaten with silk straps?
No.
Sensual pain isn't like hitting your finger with a hammer. It's intensely erotic.
What the hell, it won't kill me. I hope.
It wasn't so bad, was it?
Good evening. I'm in the mood to pierce some bagel tonight. Who wants it?
Right here. I want it.
Curtis, I'm gonna enjoy watching this.
Yeah.